paper business cards are lame, digital business cards are the way of the future. At least that's what Swft Connect wants you to believe, a brand new lifetime deal over at AppSumo. My name is Dave Swift, and you're watching That LTD Life. By the way, Swift here, no relation to Swft Connect over there, and in fact, no relation to Taylor either. Very sad about that, at least my bank account is. So I'm gonna be reviewing this tool, helping you decide if it's a good fit for all of your digital networking needs, or in-person networking needs is probably where this tool's strength really lies. It starts off at 19 bucks. I did pick up tier 2 in order to show you all of the features here. Most of the features between tier 1 and tier 2 are related to multi-user function. You get 10 users on tier 2, but you do lose out on your analytics as well as removing the Swft Connect branding. So if that's important to you, that's really the distinction between tier 1 and tier 2 if you're a single user. If you're a multi-user, you gotta go with tier 2. All right, let's get into it. Let me show you around the tool, and you can really decide for yourself if this is a good fit for your needs. I think the strength of Swft Connect is really the ability to add it to your Apple or Google Wallet so that when you're out at a conference or just meeting someone and you want to connect quickly, you can show them your phone. They can scan a QR code and exchange information right there. There's no reliance on someone typing your email correctly or maybe remembering to look you up on social media later on. It's just a real quick scan, and then everybody's contact information can be exchanged that way. Here is the admin dashboard. This is where you're going to add in all of your users. So you can see under users, I've got a directory of all of the users in my company. And if I go to groups, I can in fact segment them into specific groups like the sales group and the support group. They can have their own templates for the design of their digital business card. Templates can be managed down here, although you can't actually create a template from this screen. Templates are just basically copied from an existing user and then made available to other users. Under the gear icon for settings, there are a few things here you might want to address right away, like hiding the Swft Connect branding. If you want to turn that off, otherwise it's going to show you a little logo, basically like this. Here is a profile and it says powered by Swft at the bottom. So if you want to hide that, it's inside of that gear icon and then just toggle on the switch, which I'm gonna do now actually. So if I refresh this profile, you'll see that it goes away. You can also set up some global colors here, as well as turn on that digital wallet pass that I mentioned. I think that is a very important feature, so I do recommend turning that on if you're gonna use this tool. This screen is also where you'll get your invite link to invite other employees at your company to get signed up for this service, and you can also connect up your own custom domain so that when you share your link, it uses your own branding and not the Swft Connect branding, which honestly is not that bad. It's just Swift without the vowel .id, and then you'll have your profile name afterwards. So I don't really have a problem with that, but you should know that if you wanna connect up your own domain, you certainly can do that. All right, now don't be turned off by this profile. I've done literally nothing to create it. In fact, let me go through the process that led me to get right here. We're gonna go into our users section, and I'm going to create a new user. In fact, I'm gonna delete my existing one, and let's go ahead and create a brand new one. So that answers some questions some of you might have. Yes, you can remove people and add them back in. We did get a little error message there. If I reload the page, it looks like I am actually logged out. Okay, so funny story, I just nuked my entire account. So don't delete your last user. Go ahead and just create an additional one. User error on my part. I'm gonna go ahead and get set up with a new password. On the positive side, their support was online. Chat responded immediately and got me squared away. So this is definitely an edge case, kind of just me being silly, making YouTube videos. But the good news is I can show you this process from the beginning now. So what they want you to do when you create your first account is to add in your LinkedIn profile. Now, you can set this up manually, but if you've got a LinkedIn profile, it's gonna go ahead and scrape the information off of that, give you your profile photo and grab your title and everything. Just makes it a little bit easier. So I will go ahead and enter in my profile URL here. All right, there it is. Now I click on find profile. It's going to look me up and there I am, and I can hit continue. And now my business card has been created. Notice it just says Dave. It didn't pull in my last name. If you were very, very astute and you looked at the original profile I showed you, it said Dave SWI, which just got the first three letters of my last name. It looks like the scraping has improved in the last few days since I originally set this tool up. Little ad over here, they are selling physical cards. So kind of funny, you're getting a digital card and then turning it into a physical item. But the idea would be that you could give this to someone to scan and then they can get all of your contacts contact info. That way you don't have to pull out your phone if it's not a situation where maybe you want to have your phone available for people to scan. Okay, let's go ahead and build out my profile. So it grabbed my photo, it's got my name and my title from LinkedIn, as well as my email address and a link to my LinkedIn social media profile, but I can add anything else I'd like to this, and whatever I add right now is going to be available when I share my contact link with somebody else. So I'm gonna go ahead and add in my website link first of all. I'll click over here to links, and it's gonna pop open a screen that lets me add a section to my business card. So this will be website links, and I'm gonna actually display this so I can just say www and show this on my profile. Then I will add in a link and I'll say WordPress agency, and that's gonna be clientamp.com. And I'm gonna add in a second website where all of the content is posted, and I'm going to call this reviews and tutorials, and this will be daveswift.com. All right, so there you go. It's kind of like building out a link tree, but just a little bit more sophistication, and the intended purpose is not to share in the link of the bio of your Instagram page, although you certainly could do that, but it's really meant more for that in-person networking. We can add in additional social media links, so I'd like to connect up my YouTube page here, so I will do that. I'm gonna go ahead and add in YouTube, and I'll do my Facebook page, as well as my X profile. Now I could repeat this and go through additional steps, like I can add in text. If I wanna have a bio section here, I could just write a little message for everyone who visits the profile. I don't want that, so I'm going to delete it. There's also a gallery section if you wanna include additional photos of yourself beyond your profile photo. You could easily do that. It might be important if you're a photographer or doing something where you need to show off your work. You could have a little portfolio baked in here. There is a video section as well. If you click on this, it's going to allow you to embed a video from either YouTube or Vimeo. And I might as well try this feature out. Let's go ahead and paste in one of my most recent YouTube reviews, and I'll put it in here, and you can see what that looks like right here. If you need to book appointments, there is a calendar section. You can go ahead and embed your Calendly, or if you're using TidyCal, you could use that right here. Just click to embed your calendar. Any calendar link will work. So I've got my TidyCal link here. I'm gonna paste it in, hit save link, and we can see what that looks like right down here. You can schedule a consultation with me through this page now. There are a few other ways to add content to your profile. If you click the more button down here, there's a few items that were hidden. One is meet the team to share profile links for other members of your company, as well as a review section. If you wanna add some testimonials or reviews to your page to give yourself some social credit, you can do that. It looks like they're gonna be adding a couple of additional features like files and HTML embeds in the future, but they're not available as of the recording of this video. The other way to add content to this page is to edit the main section over here. So what we're seeing was just scraped from LinkedIn, but I can beef this up. I can change my name to include my last name if I like. I can also update my job title and change the headline. It's gonna come in automatically from LinkedIn, but if I want to make it something specific to this profile, I'll just toggle the auto switch off and write whatever I like. You saw on that main profile where my email address was listed. If I wanna add in something like a phone number or an additional email, I can definitely do that. I can add in a mobile number, an office number, or a custom number, and the email can be set to be home, work, or custom. And when you choose custom, you can give it your own label, just to be clear. In the social media section, that's where you saw my link to my LinkedIn profile. The only other profile you can add here is WhatsApp. I kind of don't like this. I wish all of the social media profiles were baked into one section. If you remember, I added a dedicated section with my Facebook, YouTube, and X profiles. It'd be nice to keep LinkedIn over there as well and just turn this off. Well, I guess I could turn it off here and then add LinkedIn over on the other side. In fact, I'm not active on LinkedIn, so I can just leave it off forever. There's a few appearance options. We can change dark mode to be on by default, and we can also change the background color. So if you'd like to set maybe a bright orange background color, don't do this, but you can. You do have the option to add in a cover photo and add in your company logo. Let's go ahead and see what those look like. All right, I've got those updated. I'm gonna go ahead and save changes. And now let's actually view the profile that we've built out. So right away, we can see the company logo right here and then the cover photo in the background. To view what this looks like on desktop, I just clicked right at the top there to view the profile, and I can see my heading. I don't really like that heading in retrospect. I'd probably remove that, but overall it's pretty nice. This stays static on the left-hand sidebar, and then I can scroll up and down to see all of the other information. And I just shrunk my browser window down here, but if I were on a mobile phone, everything would be stacked into a single column, which is probably the way I'd prefer even just for the desktop view, is just to have kind of a header at the top and not have this be static on the side, but that's how it's laid out. Now, there are a couple of links on this page that are actually very important. important. First is this one right here that says share contact info. When you click on this, whether you're on your phone or on your PC, it's going to ask for your name and email address. And in fact, you can change what information is collected here. There's some optional fields that you can make required, such as your phone number and your company name. Why does this look all funny here? I don't know, but I just updated to macOS Tahoe. So my presumption is it has something to do with that. So this is a great way to make your business card multi-directional. Rather than you giving contact info to a lead can provide their contact info to you. However, if you do want to make your info available for download, there is a little button right here. And if I click that, it's gonna go ahead and download my VCF file, which is basically like a contact you could open up on the contacts app of your computer or your phone. By the way, after someone fills out your contact form to provide their info, they will also automatically receive that contact file. So they don't need to click two things. There is the option to auto open that contact form when someone hits your page so that it just prompts them right away for their contact information. And over in the admin section, if you go to settings, contact form settings, this is where you can choose which fields are required and which fields are optional on that contact form. Now, Swift does have some analytics built in, but if you want more analytics, you can go ahead and connect this up to your Meta Pixel or Google Analytics Pixel, or even your LinkedIn Insights tag by just going to the marketing integrations and then pasting in the appropriate information into each field. But you can see here on the dashboard an idea of what it'll look like on the analytics. You can see how many views you get, how many connections are made, how many times your contact card is downloaded, and there is a little chart over time. All right, there you have it. That is Swft Connect. I found this platform to be very enjoyable to use. It was intuitive. I always understood what to do next, and it was very fast, both as someone creating profiles. If you've got to build out profiles for everyone in your company, it goes very, very quickly. And if you're a user trying to exchange information with someone, it's also very intuitive and fast loading. So if you've got a lot of profiles to build out, I think $100, $200, a one-time cost, definitely going to scratch that itch in a way that you'll be satisfied with. I'm gonna give this one a 7.4 out of 10. If you wanna grab Swft Connect or anything else over at AppSumo, I've got a link in the description and that helps support this content. Thank you very much for watching. Drop me any questions down below. I'd be happy to answer your questions, and it does help also with the YouTube algorithm. So hit that like button, get subscribed, do all the things. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next review.